So hello students, welcome back to the new video or new session wherein today we will learn, or in this video we will learn about the velocity analysis using instantaneous center method. Okay, so in this module, as we have discussed earlier, we use three methods in order to find out the velocity and accelerations of the given mechanism. The very first one is, or the very first method is relative velocity method, and then the second method is instantaneous center method. And the third method is Klein's construction, that we will discuss after solving the problems on this particular method. So what is instantaneous center? So here in this class or in this session, we are going to discuss about the basic principles or the definition of instantaneous center. Okay, what exactly is an instantaneous center? How to get instantaneous centers for the given mechanisms? What is the relation to obtain the number of instantaneous centers in the given mechanism? So all these things we learn today. So initially, let us try to analyze or get the definition of instantaneous center. So what exactly is instantaneous center? So it's an imaginary instantaneous point on which a link is assumed to rotate. So when you consider a link, that link, if it is rotating, if it's not a fixed link or if it's not a frame, so it will rotate obviously, or it will move. So when it is moving, one point of the link will be fixed or may not be fixed. Okay, if I consider a crank, the crank will rotate, okay, about the fixed point, let us say A. If we have A, B, so A is a fixed point, so B rotates with respect to A. So A is the instantaneous center. So A is the instantaneous center. Or when you consider two links, let us say two links, okay, joined together, and both the links are moving with respect to each other. So obviously at the point of contact of these two links, we can see the instantaneous center. So that is, see, I am classifying, or I have given you two examples, a link in which a point is fixed, okay, and another point is rotating with respect to that point. So that is one type of instantaneous center. I'll explain that in the next slide. And I have given you the second example wherein two links are there, and each link is moving or rotating with respect to another link. Okay, and at the point of contact, we say there is an instantaneous center about which both the links rotate. Okay, that is the center of rotation. Let us say that is the center of rotation. So that is another type of instantaneous center that we will discuss in the next slide. So first of all, this is the definition for instantaneous center. That is, it is an imaginary instantaneous point on which a link is assumed to rotate, or generally we call that as the center of rotation. And there will be no velocity for this instantaneous center. Okay, that is, the velocity for IC will be equal to zero. Okay, as well as, see, at different instances. So what is happening if two links are connected to each other and both the links are moving or rotating with respect to each other? So what will happen at every instance? There will be different location of IC, correct? The IC will be moving. That is the point of contact of these two links. Okay, whenever these two links are in motion, so what will happen? The instantaneous center will move. Okay, so when these locations, these different locations are joined together, a locus is formed, and that is normally known as a centrode. I am telling you all these things because these are important for, let us say, in gate examination, you may face this question. Okay, what it is called, or the locus formed when different locations of the ICs are joined, is normally known as, it is known as a centrode. And velocity of IC is always zero. So remember these things. These are easy to remember as well as important for some of the exams. Okay, so now we will see how to find IC. So in order to find IC, let us just consider a link AB. When I consider this link AB free to move or free to rotate, okay, how will you find the velocity of point A, and how will you find the velocity of point B? So whenever we see velocity, okay, the direction will be always perpendicular to the link or to the point, correct? So if I want to find out velocity of A, So I'll draw a perpendicular line and show this is the velocity with respect to A. And when I want to find out velocity of B, I'll draw a perpendicular line like this horizontally, and I'll say this is the velocity of B. Now, how to find out the instantaneous center? So this A will also be rotating, and B is also is free to rotate. So what I'll do, I'll draw a line from A, horizontal line from A, and a vertical line from B. The intersection point of these two lines will give us the instantaneous center. Instantaneous center. Now we can see there is a triangle created, IAB. IC is normally, okay, you can denote it as IA also. Okay. So there is a triangle created, as you can see, that is IAC. Now I'll draw the velocity triangle for this, or velocity diagram for this. So VA is represented by the vertical line OA, let us say. VB is represented by a horizontal line OB, let us say. And the resultant velocity is represented by AB, okay, or VAB, correct? So you know all these things, but anyways, now you have two triangles. As you can see closely, you have two triangles, IAB and OAB, IAB and OBA or OAB, okay? So we say that these two triangles are equal, these two triangles are equal. So when I make these triangles equal, or when I say these triangles are equal, so we can find out VA or omega, VA or omega, using this relation, that is VA is equal to omega into IA, that is instantaneous center with respect to A. Instantaneous center with respect to A, that is, see, I have extended or I have drawn a line, that is the dotted line, okay, from A, and I have drawn a dotted line from B. So those two connect at a point which is known as the instantaneous center. So if I measure IA, okay, if I measure IA or ICA, IC, okay, don't get confused, IC is nothing but I, okay, I is nothing but IC, that is instantaneous center can also be denoted as I and also be denoted as IC. So when I measure this distance of the dotted line IA and multiply it with omega, you are going to obtain VA, you are going to obtain the value VA. Okay, similarly, if you want VB, then just multiply the omega or angular velocity with IB, that is the dotted line BIC or ICB or BI or IB. Okay, now in some problems, or when we solve the problems, you'll come to understand that. But anyways, so there are ratios, or this relation can be used in order to find out omega. In order to find out omega, or using this relation, you can even find out VA or VB, that is VA by IA is equal to VB by IB, that is equal to omega. So omega is equal to VA by IA, that is equal to VB by IB. Now, okay, this is how you need, you will find out the velocities of the given points on the links. Okay, and you can find out the angular velocity also, that is omega. Okay, so now initially, or at the start of the program, problem, you need to first find out how many ICs are there in the given mechanism. So how to do that? For that we have a relation. So okay, this is another relation. VB is represented by OB of OA, VA is represented by OA divided by IA, okay, and OB divided by IB will give you omega. So in order to find out the number of ICs in the given mechanism, what I'll do is, I'll consider small n as the number of links, capital N as the number of ICs. Okay, so now we have a relation. So this is the relation to find out the number of ICs, that is N is equal to capital N is equal to small n into N minus 1 divided by 2, N minus 1 divided by 2. Now, let us see the types of ICs. As I have already discussed, I told you about the two types of ICs initially, that is the fixed and permanent. Okay, we will see that. So let us consider a link which is fixed. Okay, so these two things which I have drawn, okay, represents the fixed link. Now I'll consider another link, let us say link 2, then link 3 and link 4. Okay, so as we know and as we have already discussed, so always when I consider two links, the point of contact of these two links will be the IC. That is, so I have drawn some dotted lines. I'll tell you what is this. Okay, first of all, let us find out the first IC, that is 1, 2. Link 1 and link 2 are in contact at that particular point where we represent the IC for these two links, that is 1, 2. I12 can also be written there. Now, when we consider link 2 and link 3, okay, both of them are in contact at that particular point. Okay, and when both rotate with respect to each other, okay, relatively, then we will find an instantaneous center 2, 3 over there. Next, when I consider 3, 4, so this is the instantaneous center 3, 4, and next then when I consider 4, 1, this is the instantaneous center 1, 4. So this is 1, 3 and this is 2, 4. I'll tell you what exactly are these things. Okay, so now first of all we need to find out how many ICs are there in the given mechanism. So it's a 4-bar mechanism, that is 4 links are there. Okay, 4-bar chain or 4-bar mechanism, so 4 links are there. So we know the formula, capital N is equal to small n into n minus 1 divided by 2. Okay, so small n is 4, so when you calculate the number of ICs, it will be 6. So initially we had only 4 ICs, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4 and 1, 4. So what about other two? What about other two? So these are the ICs which we can have. So first link, that is the fixed link with all the other links, 1, 2, 1, 3 and 1, 4. Then second link is already okay, we have an instantaneous center with the first link, that is 1, 2, it has been written already. So remaining will be 2, 3 and 2, 4. So third link, it's been written with respect to 1 and with respect to 2 also. So finally we will be having 3, 4. So these are the 6 instantaneous centers we have to find and locate in the given mechanism. Okay, initially, then we will find out the velocities and okay, linear velocities as well as the angular velocities in the problem. First you need to know and understand how to locate the instantaneous centers. Okay, for all the problems locating the instantaneous centers will remain same. So when I consider a 4-bar mechanism, so these are the instantaneous centers we need to locate. So we have located 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4 and 1, 4. Remaining is 1, 3 and 2, 4. 1, 3 and 2, 4. Okay. So in order to do that, what I'll do is I'll consider a circle. For all the problems, you please follow the same method. Consider the circle. So 4 links are there. I'll mark 1, 2, 3 and 4, or I'll cut the circle. Okay, like this, 1, 2, 3 and 4. I'll connect 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4 and 4 to 1. Okay, so we have 1, 2, we have 1, 4, we have 2, 3, we have 3, 4. Remaining is 1, 3 and 1, 4. Now, draw the diagonal with a dotted line, 1 and 3. Draw the diagonal with a dotted line, one dotted line connecting 1 to 3. So this is what we need to find out, right? This is what we need to find out, the instantaneous center 1, 3. So that is why. So connect 1 to 3 using the diagonal. Now, see, this diagonal consists of two triangles on both the sides. Consists of two triangles on both the sides. One is 1, 2 and 2, 3. One is 1, 2 and 2, 3. On the other side, 1, 4 and 3, 4. 1, 4 and 3, 4. As you can see, okay, just observe very carefully. So we need to find out the IC 1, 3. So how to find out IC 1, 3? So connect 1 to 3. Okay, so now this line or the diagonal consists of two triangles on both the sides. One is 1, 2 and 2, 3, consisting of the instantaneous centers 1, 2 and 2, 3. Where exactly it is? Say 1, 2 is here. See, 1, 2 is here, then 2, 3 is here, correct? So draw a line or extend the line. Now, another one is 1, 4 and 4, 3, 1, 4 and 4, 3 or 3, 4. So this is 1, 4, this is 3, 4, extend the line. So wherever these two lines intersect, you will find the, you will find the instantaneous center 1, 3. instantaneous center 1 3. Hope you understood this. Now I'll explain another instantaneous center, how to find it out, so you will clearly understand then. So now we need to find out 2 4. 2 4 is not found out, so we need to find out 2 4, instantaneous center 2 4. Now I will join 2 to 4. Now I'll join 2 to 4 like this. Okay, this 2 4 line, okay, which I have drawn now, or the diagonal, consists of two triangles on both the sides. Two triangles on both the sides, correct? So one is 2 3 and 3 4 on one side, 2 3 and 3 4 on one side. So where it is 2 3 and 3 4, so extend that line. Next, 1 2 and 1 4 on the other side, 1 2 and 1 4 on the other side. Okay, so that will give you the instantaneous center 2 4. So now extend both the lines. Okay, now they meet at a point which is the instantaneous center 2 4. This is how we need to find out the instantaneous centers. So finding out velocities and finding out the angular velocities v and omega, okay, we will discuss about that when we discuss the problems. You will clearly understand over that. So this is the initial step. If you do this, the next step is very easy for you people. Okay, so now types of ICs. So when I say 12 and 14, so they do not move, they are fixed, correct? So such ICs are normally known as fixed ICs. Such ICs are normally known as fixed ICs. Now when you consider 2 3 and 2 4, when you consider 2 3 and 2 4, okay, they will change their position at different instances, correct? They will change their position at different instances because the links 2, 3 and 4 will be rotating or moving. Rotating or moving. Hence, they will change their positions. But those links are permanent links with respect to the mechanism. So, they will not go anywhere. They are not going anywhere. Correct? They are not going anywhere. They are not detachable. They are part of the mechanism itself. So, therefore, these ICs 2, 3 and 3, 4 are normally known as permanent ICs. These ICs are known as permanent ICs. Now we have two more ICs, 1, 3 and 2, 4. Okay, so these are neither fixed nor permanent. So these are neither fixed nor permanent because the ICs itself will change their positions, obviously here. Okay, whenever, okay, link 4 and link 3 are moving and link 2 is also moving, okay, you will find different, okay, positions of these ICs. So hence these are neither fixed nor permanent ICs. So hope you understood the types of ICs also. Next, we will be discussing about the Arnold-Kennedy theorem. Okay, statement of the theorem is like this. If three plane bodies are in relative motion, okay, if three plane bodies are in relative motion, then the three ICs must be in a straight line. So that's what we have seen here, correct? See here. See, in order to find out 1, 3 and 2, 4, okay, 2, 3 and 3, 4, instantaneous centers, okay, they are exactly in a straight line. If they are not in a straight line, you will not find out the IC 2, 4. Correct, 1, 2 and 1, 4 also, they are in a straight line. So similarly, 1, 2, 2, 3 are also in a straight line so that you can find out 1, 3. 1, 4, 3, 4 is also in a straight line so that you can find out 1, 3. Okay, both the lines intersect and you have found out the ICs. But if they do not lie in a straight line, so obviously, I'll give you an example and I'll explain. So the statement is like this. If three plane bodies are in relative motion, if three plane bodies are in relative motion, then the three ICs must be in a straight line. Then three ICs must be in a straight line. Now let us consider an example. Link 1, link 2 and link 3. So this is the mechanism given. Okay. So now, see, this is the instantaneous center 1, 2 with respect to 1 and 2, link 1 and 2. So this is the instantaneous center 1, 3 with respect to 1 and 3. And this is the instantaneous center 2, 3 with respect to 2 and 3. Okay. So when you find out the velocities, okay, when you find out the velocity with respect to link 1, okay, you will get See, when I find out velocity for link 3, so this is the velocity for link 3, perpendicular to link 3. Correct? And this is for link 4. Correct. So now, as you can see, the instantaneous centers 1, 2 and 1, 3, they lie in a straight line. But 2, 3, does not come in that line or on that line. So hence Kennedy's theorem, okay, does not fit for this mechanism. Correct? So always in order to obtain ICs and in order to obtain the velocities, okay, for a given mechanism, the mechanism should satisfy the Arnold Kennedy theorem. Okay, so this is all for now. We will discuss about the Klein's construction in the next video. So the problems on this method, that is the instantaneous center method, will be solved after this video. And one problem on four bar mechanism, one problem on slider crank mechanism, and a complex mechanism also. Three problems we will solve, and we'll discuss how to find out the ICs, how to locate ICs, and how to find out velocities as well as linear velocities as well as the angular velocities for the given mechanism. Okay, so that's all for now. Thank you very much, guys. Okay, in the next class or in the next session, we will be discussing about the problems, okay, which are based on the instantaneous center method. Thank you very much.